Welcome to T-Max, one of the top 4x4 off-road brands. Today we'd like to focus on the do-it-yourself installation of the e-board for the JK Wrangler. So from this video, we can learn about the components, the working principles, installation, safety precautions, and advantages. So let's get started. So before we go to installation of the e-board, let's just have a look at the way it works. When your car door opens, the e-board automatically comes down. When you shut your door, the e-board automatically comes back up. When it's up, it doesn't affect the overall performance of the car. And when it's down, very convenient for women and children. So this is a JK Wrangler without e-boards. These are the tools you're going to need for the assembly process. The three main bolts that we demonstrated are replicated here, and here, and here. To take off the old board, we simply have to take three main bolts off from here, and the nuts off behind here. This is the fixed board that we'll remove. Okay, so let's just check the components of the e-board before assembly. So these are the main components of the e-board. We have four motor units, two for each side. Two boards, one for each side. We have the main wiring harness, a control unit, two mounting brackets, various nuts and bolts that need to fit the unit. Key points. Carefully check the e-board specification and component parts according to fitting instruction to make sure the model is correct and all parts are complete. Prepare all the toolkits. To install the control unit, we first need to open the bonnet. Inside the bonnet, we locate the battery. In some cars it's on the right-hand side, and in others it's on the left-hand side. Once we've located the battery, we then are able to install the control unit on either the left or right-hand side. Depending on which side it goes, there is a corresponding hole to be able to run the cable from the control unit back into the vehicle. This is our control unit, the interface, photosensitive cell, a fuse, positive and a negative for the battery connection, our signal control cables, and our two cables for the motor control cables. Make sure the control unit is stable and attached to the cable. First, we need to remove the fuse. The fuse is used safeguard the unit against short circuits. And then we need to connect the interface to the control unit. Next, we need to insert the signal cables and the control cables into the hole on the right hand side. And next, we need to insert the motor cable into the other side of the car. And lastly, we need to secure the cable to the vehicle with our zip ties and remove any excess zip tie. So after we've run the wires through here, we can move on to the next step. We need to remove the carpet cover from the passenger side.
Next we need to remove back the carpet so we can take out the seal plug to push the cable through.
And we need to stab a hole in the seal plug to insert the wires. And then we need to thread the cable through the seal plug. Step 1. Connect the signal cable by connectors. Find the grey purple cable on the vehicle and connect it to the short white signal cable. Two door vehicles do not need this step. Step 2. Find the white purple cable on the vehicle and connect it to the long brown signal cable. Step 3. Find the yellow purple cable on the vehicle and connect it to the short brown signal cable. Two door vehicles once again do not need this step. Then we need to find the longest white cable, feed it under the carpet, up through here, and over onto the driver's side. Step 5. Open the driver's door and pry open this cover. Find the purple signal cable of the driver's door. Connect it to the long white signal cable by connectors. Key points. The controller is central nervous system of eBoard. Please make sure all cables connect correctly. Must avoid any misconnection. All cables must be fixed as requirement. Prevent any messy cable. Okay, this is the stepping board, and these are our motor units. They're clearly marked for the correct position. Positions are A2 and A3. Before installation, ensure that they're fully extended to fit on. And now it's time to begin the linkage installation. First, we start with the spacer bracket by bolting it into place. Okay, we need to tighten this bolt right up. Firstly, attach this bolt through this hole, and then we attach it to the spacer bracket. Please ensure you don't tighten this bolt right up, as it may need further adjustment. Now we need to thread the cable along the chassis line and over this bolt here. The front motor unit also needs to be bolted into place. Please ensure you don't tighten it up too much also, as it may need further adjustment as well. Then we need to put the board on. One of the final parts of the installation is to raise the piston to secure the bar. Please make sure you install the eBoard in the required sequence. Please do not tighten the linkage first. The board will still need to be adjusted.
Now we need to check all the connections and fuses and check whether the door opens and shuts. And when all the connections are okay, tighten all the bolts. If your eBoard
has an LED light, you need to attach the photosensitive cell. Running the cable up through here. If you open or close the vehicle door, the e-board can't work, electric fault, battery cable connection fault, signal cable connection fault, controller fault, motor fault, wrong control signal, please check the cable connection. Mechanical failure, foreign body block the board motion, front and rear linkage is not in plane. Double motors drive each side design. Keep enough power for e-board working. Completely avoid unilateral sag. The tensional assist system can offset the board's weight. The motor can work normally from 40 degrees Celsius to over 80 degrees Celsius. Safety intelligent control system design. The e-board can stop automatically when they have obstacles. Anti-skid and anti-theft. International patents. Unique 6-bar linkage can achieve optimized trajectory control. Much more reliable, small size, low noise. Improved control system, adopt an imported military component. Make e-board work much more smooth and stable. Durability passed 10,000 times loading testing. Certified by TS16949. Automotive, industrial, production and service management system certification. 2 years or 50,000 kilometre warranty. PICC million RMB insurance. Suitable, streamlined design makes the vehicle appearance perfect. Periodic inspection every 3 months. Check the linkage for normal working. Check cable connection, also check for abrasion of exposed cable. Check the bolt of motor and board. Special situation inspection, the linkage and board must be cleaned if sediment. The linkage and board must be cleaned if frozen.